Okay, so today we want to perform the A pre-trip for the DMV on these vehicles, truck and trailer, Class A. Okay, they're breaking the pre-trip. They're breaking in three sections, A, B, and C. So what I'm gonna perform it right now is the A. Another video I'm gonna perform in the B, and then I will perform in the C. Every single pre-trip is talking about the couplings, so I'm gonna do pre-trips and couplings in every single video. Okay, so the A pre-trip, you guys will see, I will detail in my pre-trip because I want to get all my points. Okay, first thing I want to mention is my clearance lights. They're amber in color, they're not cracked or broken, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. For my my clearance lights, I will touch in my windshield. I will inspect my windshield, and I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked or broken or excessive peeling, and it's securely mounted by the rubber seal. My rubber seal on my windshield is not excessively worn or torn, and it's a full contact to the vehicle. These ones right here, this is my windshield wipers. I wanna make sure they're securely attached to the arm securely attached to the vehicle, no missing hardware. The windshield wiper blade, I wanna make sure it's not ripped or torn, and it's a full contact to the windshield. From there, I'm gonna put myself in front of the lights, and I'm gonna face in to the front of the vehicle. But I'm gonna touch in this part right here, and this part right here. This is the cover of the lights. It's clear in color, it's not cracked or broken, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. The light right here, and the light right here. These lights represent my low beam and my high beam. They're not cracked or broken, and they're securely mounted to the vehicle. The amber lights on the side, they represent my left turn signal, my right turn signal, my forward flashers, and my running lights. Now I'm gonna look in the front of the vehicle, and I'm gonna make sure it's not leaning to either side, indicating the suspension problem. I'm gonna look under the vehicle, I'm gonna make sure it's no puddles, indicating any type of fluid is leaking, any hanging hose or hanging wire. If my vehicle was leaning to either side, indicating the suspension problem, it can be a shock absorber, leaf spring hanger, or a flat tire, or that my load is shifting. Now I'm gonna open the hood. I'm gonna open the hood by three points of contact. I'm gonna have my foot on the floor and the other foot right here. And with my two hands, I will open the hood. Once I open the hood, I will start my inspection right here. And most of the trucks that we have, the test truck especially that going to the DMV, you guys will have the windshield washer reservoir, you guys will have it right here. The windshield washer reservoir, you guys are gonna point it, it's right here. It's not cracked or broken or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. As I need to fill it up, I will open this door, and the cap will be here. The cap for my windshield washer reservoir is not cracked or broken, and it's securely mounted, and it will not leak. And the seal inside is not necessarily worn or torn. My windshield washer reservoir is on the proper level. From there, I'm gonna come into this section right here. First thing I'm gonna inspect is my coolant reservoir. My coolant reservoir is not cracked or broken or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. The cap for my coolant reservoir is on the lock position, it's not cracked or broken or leaking, and the rubber seal inside is not excessively worn or torn. My coolant reservoir is on the proper level. From there, I'm gonna inspect my alternator. My alternator, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked or broken, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. The wires for my alternator, I wanna make sure they're properly routed, no exposed wire, no frayed wire, securely mounted, no missing hardware. Now, I'm gonna point it right here in the middle. I'm gonna inspect my water pump. My water pump is not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. My water pump and my alternator, they're belt-driven, and I will inspect my belt. My belt is not excessively worn or torn, and it's a full contact to the vehicle. If I pull on it from the center point, it should be no more than 3/4 of the play. From there, to be detailed in my pre-trip, I want to inspect all the hoses, and I will touch in all the hoses on this side of the vehicle. I'm gonna make sure there's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. I will inspect all the wires on this side of the vehicle. I'm gonna make sure they're properly routed, no exposed wire, no frayed wire, securely mounted, no missing hardware. With that, I'm finished this section. Now we wanna go to the other side. On this side of the vehicle, I'm gonna point it in the DMV. The tires has to be straight. I turn into the left, so that way you guys can see all the parts that I'm gonna mention. Okay, but I'm gonna start from the top. First thing I'm gonna inspect is my oil cap. My oil cap is not cracked or broken or leaking, and it's on the lock position, and the rubber seal inside is not excessively worn or torn, and it will not leak. For my oil cap, I will inspect my oil stick. My oil stick, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked, broken or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. If I need to check the oil on my vehicle, I will pull it out, wipe it in, reinsert it, take it out, and check the level of my oil. If I need to add oil, I will add it through the cap by the gallon. Now I'm gonna inspect my air compressor. My air compressor is right here in the back. My air compressor is not cracked, broken, or leaking, and is securely mounted, no missing hardware. Under my air compressor is gonna be my power steering pump. My power steering pump is not cracked or broken or leaking, and is securely mounted, no missing hardware. My air compressor and my power steering pump, they're gear driven. From there, I'm gonna inspect my steering column or steering shaft. I wanna make sure it's not cracked or broken, and is securely mounted, no missing hardware. It's securely mounted by two U-joints. My two U-joints, I have one here and one on the top. I wanna make sure they're not cracked or broken, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. It's a pull on it on my steering column. It should be no more than 10 degrees of play. From there, I wanna inspect my steering box. My steering box, I wanna make sure it's not cracked or broken, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware, and it's not leaking. This is my power steering reservoir. My power steering reservoir is not cracked or broken or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. And it's on the proper level. If I need to add it fluid, I will add it through the cap. The cap for my power steering reservoir is not cracked, broken, or leaking, and is securely mounted, no missing hardware. Securely mounted, and it's on the lock position. The rubber seal inside is not excessively worn or torn, and it will not leak. I will inspect the hose for my power steering reservoir. The hose for my power steering reservoir is no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and is securely mounted, no missing hardware. Before I move from here, I will inspect all the hoses on this side of the vehicle. I want to make sure it's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. I will inspect all the wires on this side of the vehicle. I want to make sure they're properly routed, no exposed wire, no frayed wire, securely mounted, no missing hardware. From there, I want to inspect the frame. The frame on this side of the vehicle, I want to make sure it's not cracked or broken, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. Doesn't have any legal holes or legal welds. From my frame, I want to inspect this section right here. This is the leaf spring hangers or leaf spring mounts. I have one here and one in the back. My leaf spring hangers, I want to make sure they're not cracked or broken, they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. This part right here is my leaf spring bushing. My leaf spring bushing, I want to make sure it's not cracked or broken or excessively worn or torn, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. From there, I will touch in my leaf springs. My leaf springs, I want to make sure they're not cracked or broken or shifting, and they're securely mounted by two U-bolts, shim, spacers, and four nuts under. From there, I will inspect my shock absorber and my shock absorber mounts. I want to make sure they're not cracked or broken, they're securely mounted, no missing hardware, and my shock absorber is not leaking. From there, I'm gonna come into this section right here. This one right here is the pitman arm. My pitman arm, my drag line, my upper, and my lower control arm, and my tie rod. I'm gonna make sure they're not cracked or broken, they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. And they're securely mounted by the castle nuts and carrier pin. I have three. I have one here, one in here, and one under, okay? So from there, I'm gonna start inspecting close to the tire. First, I want to inspect the hose. This is my air brake hose. I want to make sure it's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. This one right here is my brake chamber and my brake chamber clamp. I want to make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. This one right here, this is the push rod. And this one in the middle is my lock adjuster. I'm gonna make sure they're not cracked or broken, and they're securely mounted, and they're securely mounted by the pin and cutter pin. I have two, one in front and one in the back. If I pull on it when my brakes are released, it should be no more than 1 inch of the play. From there, I'm gonna start inspecting the tire. The tire and every single pre-trip is very important. If you guys missing something in the tire, most likely you guys will fail. If you guys missing a couple more things from the section that you guys inspected. Every single pre-treat have a tire. So we're gonna inspect the front tire. And then the way to inspect it, I'm gonna point it right here in the middle. This is my inside half seal. And this is my outside half seal. I wanna make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. You see what's leaking, I will see puddle or spin trail. If I need to add it fluid, I will add it through this cap. The cap for my half seal is not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's on the lock position. From there, we're gonna go inside the tire. And as you see the tire, first thing that we're gonna inspect is the brake liners. This is the brake liners. Okay, my brake liners is not cracked or broken. They're securely mounted to the vehicle, no missing hardware. They're not allowed to have less than 1/4 of an inch of the thinnest point. This part right here is my brake drum. My brake drum is not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted. Between my brake liners and my brake drum, free of debris, grease, or any other contamination. And my brake drum is not have any sign of decoloration indicating the overheating problem. From there, we're gonna come into the tire. And we want to be specific on the tire. This is a steering tire. It's not allowed to be regrouped, recapped, or retraped. And it's not allowed to have less than 40 seconds on the deepest point. My inside tire, my outside tire, and the face of my tire. I want to make sure it's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks. And it's securely mounted to my rim. If I need to check the air on my tire, I will do it through the ball stamps. My ball stamp, I wanna make sure it's not cracked or broken or leaking and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. The cap for my ball stamp, I wanna make sure it's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted and it's not leaking. The air specification on my tires is 110 PSI or manufacturer specifications. The way I inspect this tire, I will inspect the tire on the other side. This concludes my eighth pre-trip. Once you say this concludes my eighth pre-trip, it's nothing to add. You pass or you fail. From here, I'm gonna inspect my couplings. Couplings is whatever connecting the truck to the trailer. So the first thing we're gonna inspect it is gonna be the hoses. This is my emergency hose, and this is my service hose. Okay, I'm gonna make sure there's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and they're securely mounted to the tractor, and they're securely mounted to the trailer. They're securely mounted to the trailer by that glad hand and the glad hand receivers. I have the emergency and I have the service one. I wanna make sure they're not cracked, broken, or leaking, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. The rubber seal in between my glad hand and my glad hand receiver is not excessively worn or torn, and it will not leak in. This is my power cord or electrical cord. I wanna make sure it's securely mounted to my tractor and it's securely mounted to my trailer. I wanna make sure it's properly routed, no exposed wire, no frayed wire, securely mounted, and it's no black tape. That's the keyword, no black tape. From there, I'm gonna go under my trailer, and the first thing I'm gonna inspect is this section right here. This is the apron of the trailer. The apron of the trailer is not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted. This one is welded, so I'm gonna inspect the weld. I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked, welding, or miswelding. Next section I'm gonna inspect is this one right here. This is the fifth wheel. My fifth wheel is not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted. Between my apron and my fifth wheel is no daylight and they're properly greased. This one right here is my fifth wheel lever. My fifth wheel lever, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware, and it's on the lock position. My fifth wheel is securely mounted to the platform. This one is bolted, but the test truck is a pin and carry pin, by the pin and carry pin. The platform is securely mounted to the frame. It's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted. This one is bolted, so I'm gonna inspect all the bolts that are present and they're on the lock position, they're not cracked or broken. From there, we're gonna go to the back. We're gonna go inside and we're just gonna point it right in the middle. That's the kingpin. The kingpin is not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted. It's on the lock position by the locking jaw. My locking jaw is not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. It's on the lock position around the chain of the kingpin. From there, we're gonna come in outside again, and we're gonna mention that between my landing gear and my vehicle is the proper distance to perform a 90-degree turn. This is a complete eight pre-trip white couplings.